So once these lock since flags have been flipped, then all of the processors that have been waiting on these lock since as the respective nodes, they're going to be released and everybody is now awake. So the tree barrier is a fairly intuitive algorithm that builds on the simple centralized sense reversal barrier, except that it breaks up this N processors into K-sized groups so that they can all do spinning on a less contentious set of shared variables. So that's good. That it is it's a recursive algorithm that builds on the centralized sense reversal algorithm and allows scaling up to a large number of processors, because the amount of sharing is limited to K, and so long as the K is small, like 2 or 4, then the amount of contention for shared variables is limited to that number. So those are all good things about that, but there are lots of problems as well. The first problem that I want you to notice is that the spin location is not statically determined for each processor. So for instance, if you take this particular execution that I've shown you in this picture, P0 happens to arrive later than P1. So P1 is the first to arrive here. And so when P1 arrived here, it decremented count and it realized that, oh, the count is not 0, I'm going to spin here. And P0 arrived later, and that's why it went up to the next level and ended up spinning on this lock sense variable over here. So in another execution of the same program, it is possible that P0 arrives first. If P0 arrives first, then it'll spin on its lock sense variable that is in this data structure, and P1 will be the second guy to arrive, and therefore he'll be the guy that'll move up. And he'll be the guy that'll be spinning on this lock sense flag. So the lock sense flag that a particular processor is going to spin on is not statically determined, but it is dynamically determined depending on the arrival pattern of all these processors at a barrier. And this arrival pattern obviously is going to be different for different runs of the program, since it depends on the amount of code that is getting executed on each one of these processors and other variables such as how busy that processor is and so on. And the second source of problem is that the airiness of the tree determines the amount of contention for shared variables. I mentioned that, you know, here it is shown with two processors, but if you increase the airiness of the tree to be K to be something more than 2, maybe 4 or 8 or something like that, and if you have a large-scale multiprocessor with 1,000 processors, the airiness of the tree may be much more than 2. And in that case, the amount of contention for shared data structures is going to be significant, and that can result in more contention on the network as well. The other issue with this tree barrier is that it depends on whether our multiprocessor that we are executing this algorithm on is cache coherent or not cache coherent. If it is cache coherent multiprocessor, then you know the spin, even though it's on a particular variable, it could be encached in a private cache, and therefore the cache coherent hardware will indicate when this spin variable changes value. But if it's a non-cache coherent multiprocessor, the fact that the spin variable that we have to associate with a particular processor is not static but dynamic means that the spin may actually be happening for P0 on a remote memory. Remember I mentioned to you that one of the styles of architecture is the distributed shared memory architecture. Sometimes the distributed shared memory architecture is also called a non-uniform memory access architecture, or NUMA. And the reason it is called NUMA architecture is because the access to local memory for a particular processor is going to be faster than the processor's access to a remote memory. And if you don't have cache coherence, then the spinning that has to be done on a remote memory, and that goes through the network. And so static association of the spin location of the processor is very, very crucial if it's a non-cache coherent shared memory machine. So the next algorithm that I'm going to describe to you is due to the authors of the paper that we are reviewing in this lesson, which is Malakrami and Scott. And for this reason, that algorithm is going to be called MCS barrier. It's also a tree barrier, but you'll see that in the MCS algorithm, the spin location is statically determined as opposed to the dynamic situation that you have in the hierarchical tree barrier here.